Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, I have five chart tips for you in Excel. The fifth one, I hope, blows you away. I thought about making just a really short video on the fifth tip, but I decided, no, let me just quickly cover five tips that actually lead you where I'm headed. So let's just go ahead and dive in. So first of all, this file will be available for you. Check the description. There'll be a link to my website. You don't have to sign up for anything. You can just download it. So here we go with tip number one. I'm going to highlight this data right here. I'm on a PC, but I'll tell you the Mac keyboard shortcuts also. The F11 function key. We'll put a chart on a new worksheet. On the Mac, it may be function F11. Another keyboard tip, so this is still number one, Alt F1, we'll put the chart here on this worksheet. Mac users, function, option F1, I don't have a Mac, but I'm assuming that that'll work. So there's number one out of the way. Number two, if you want to make a pie chart, unlike a column or a bar chart, you're limited to what you can chart. So I'm going to highlight manufacturers, I'm going to hold down the CTRL key, get the profit, and then here is my pie chart right there, and there's some percentages right up here under the chart styles. That was tip number two right there. Tip number three, I'm going to select this data right here. Alt F1, keep it simple, use what I just taught you. But now I want to add something else to the chart. Maybe I want to add the expenses. Well, the expenses I could easily add by just pulling this over. I'm going to undo, Control Z. I'm making this up, act like it's the profit that I want to add. Well, but I don't want the expenses. So I'm going to highlight this range, Control C or right click and copy. Click inside your chart first. So that was the left click and then right click and paste or Control V is how you add items not touching. One more time on this one. I'm going to chart this real quick, Alt F1. So I've got Toyota and GM. I don't care about Ford, but I want Kia. Same steps, copy, left click, right click, paste. There you go, Toyota, GM, Kia. I'm going to get rid of these charts real quick just to keep this clean. So that was non-adjacent columns or non-adjacent rows. The combo chart, here we go again, and I'm still going to use that Control key. So I've got this data charted, Alt F1, there's my column chart. I want to put in some percentages, same steps, copy, right click, paste. It worked. In case you're saying, so there's an extra tip in here. In case you're saying, Chris, I don't see anything. I'm trying to chart 0.11 in cell E2 versus 500,000 in cell B2. So of course it's not going to work. It's there, you can't see it. So here's the extra tip. The reason I know it's there, if I come to this plus sign right here, it says chart elements, and I go to the legend, and I'm going to put the legend at the top. There's percentage. So here is combo chart. It's one of my favorite charts. Whenever you have numbers that are way apart from each other, it's almost always a combo chart. One other tip for you. I'm in this chart right now. So up on the ribbon, I've got tabs, home, insert, draw, page layout. The chart design and chart format or just format, those are contextual tabs. So if I click outside the chart, I'm over in column K, they don't show up. Click inside the chart, that is called a contextual tab. The chart design and there's format, those both deal with charts. But here we go, I need to change the chart type. Combo is always at the bottom, and I usually pick the second one right here, one, and there's two. When I click on two, look, it adds that second axis over here. Click OK, and there you go. Last one, and it's the reason hopefully you came here. All the other ones were great too, though, in case you didn't know those. I only want to chart, this is a cool chart, watch this. I'm only going to chart this information here. I'm going to go with the mouse this time, insert, That is exactly the same as Alt F1. There you go. I want the percentages over in column E, but I don't want to do a combo chart that I just did. So watch this trick. Click inside the chart. Come over here, click. I want to go to data labels, center. You can see what it's doing here with the data labels. I don't care for any of these. In this example, I'm going to go to more options. There we go. It's this 1, 2, 3, fourth icon over here. Notice it's under format data labels. Click here, label options. When I'm under label options, here's the trick. Value from cells. So before I do this, I'm going to turn this one off, turn that one off. Value from cells. What cells do you want to show in this chart? I want to show the percentages. I did not select cell E1. I highlighted E2 to E5. Click OK, and how about that right there? So I'm showing those percentages right there. Let's test this. Toyota's 500,000 and 445, giving us a profit of 55,000. I made a mistake. It's not 500,000, it's 750,000, which means our profit should go way up, which means our percentage should go way up. And look at that, Toyota went up to 41%. It's in cell E2, and it's the very first column in my chart. So there is a cool feature right there. Click inside the chart, come here, go to data labels, pick more options, fourth icon, data label options, values from cell, and highlight those percentages. How about that trick? Feel free to subscribe. If you have any comments or questions, put them down below. Ring the bell. I appreciate your time. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.